Today is a very special day in our school calendar. We are very happy to have our Honorable Minister Rauf Hakim, Minister of City Planning, Water Supply and Higher Education, as the chief guest for Islamic Day 2019. On behalf of the college, I extend a cordial welcome to you. Population and 115 academic staff. We are proud to say that our students have excelled not only in academic field but also in extracurricular activities, bringing honor to the college in many occasions at zonal, district, provincial and national level as well.
Now one group is saying it is your responsibility. They say we are saying it is their responsibility. It is our responsibility. Ape yutu kama ape waga kima ape okkoma la ekathu vela api kohomada yam kisi panimidiya maadhyen kiyenawana nikan eka share karanne pa hitanna meka satya mokadda vivrutha dayasin balanna vivrutha manasin balanna satya da avankawa tamange sittula hitanna meema kiyenawana maget ekka jeevath wen asal wasu ekala man monada karala thiyenne असल वस्तु मगे संबंध काम मुखद कुरान इस्लाम असल वस्तु के कुछ मग पेन्वीम सह ये बदो अपट वग कीम लादील असल वस्यु अपे ले जाति वड अपट वग कीम असल वस्यु नम अपि ये असल वस्यु गन परिसरे गन आगमे अपि एक पत्ताई वैडिये म कथा होने मम एक मम वग कीम की नाम मुस्लिम आगमिक नायक है कनगाटे मम प्रकाश करना अभी आगमें एक पत्ताई हेम विनेम कथा करे आगम की अने समस्त वशी हेम त्याम कथा करुत हेम श्रेष्ठ अभी धनुम लादयुत ये मे इन दंग अभी शिशु मे गण अद्यन करीम तुम तमाइ अभी दीवेन अद्यापन तुम तमाइ अभी मनस एक अभी यपीम सदहा मनुष्य गौरव सह मनुष्य
इट इज अ सिंगुलर ऑनर फॉर मी टू बी प्रेजेंट हियर for a variety of reasons. Firstly, this school, as stated by your director of education and the principal who spoke before me, appears to be at a very leading position when it comes to the performance, whether in academic activities or in extracurricular activities, within the rest of the schools in this division. And particularly since this school caters to Muslim girl child with numbers amounting to almost 2,600 or so, it is one of those largest institutions that provide education for our future leaders among the ladies belonging to the Muslim community in particular. This zone also perhaps is having several leading schools at the national level. So to compete with such schools and to be shoulder to shoulder when it comes to the performance is a very challenging task. And in meeting those challenges, our girls, and particularly your teachers and others involved in the development of the school, should be congratulated for maintaining those high standards. Then I'm also personally pleased that your principal happens to be my own cousin. Her father and my father are brothers. She's a blood sister of mine. So that also gives me a special pleasure. And it so happens that her father and my father were both teachers and principals of schools. So we come from a teaching tradition. Both your principal and me both would have perhaps lived in several principal quarters. I have lived in almost four principal quarters in this country. So I have grown up within a school community all my life, most of the time. Even when I came to Colombo, I stayed with another brother of my father who happened to teach at Royal College Colombo when I entered Royal College Colombo. So we have been always under the tutelage of teachers and uncles, and such has been my upbringing. And therefore, it gives me a great pleasure to come into a school community and address them on different occasions. These are difficult times for the entire country. These are challenging times, particularly when we have faced what we had to face on the 21st of April, which shocked the conscience of the entire nation. And that has resulted in our community, the Muslim community, having to face unknown new challenges, prejudices, difficulties when it comes to the way we dress, way we interact with the rest of the communities. Even when we had to use Arabic as a language, and I was telling Mr. Premathilaka when he was seated, when all the welcome songs and the rest of the things are all in Arabic language, to a certain extent, the antipathy towards Muslims, which have become highly focused and very prejudiced in its approach, has resulted in coming to the extent of hating the Arabic language, thinking that since Islam came from Saudi Arabia and the Middle East, and people are equating Islam with terrorism. And these are such challenging times because we need to separate one from the other. The World Muslim League Secretary General came a few days ago as a guest of the government, and he was received not only by the President, the Prime Minister, the Leader of the Opposition, and everybody in a very ceremonial way. And he visited all the leading Buddhist chapters in the country. Asgiriya Malvatta and all the leading Buddhist monks were present when he was given a felicitation. But nevertheless, the campaign to vilify and demonize Islam, Muslims, Arabic language, the Quran, everything is going on at a pace, at some speed at which we are all astonished, and we are trying to explain that such attitude should be avoided. But yet we are facing these challenges. We need to explain as to how, now particularly these days. Now yesterday in cabinet, I had to resist very hard to prevent permanent legislation being brought about trying to regulate lifestyle issues, particularly garments pertaining to women. So when dealing with these subjects, we need to also understand the fears and anxiety among the other communities. So this needs to be addressed in earnest, going back to the roots. Sometimes it is not simply to the outside community, even within our community, we face challenges. Now I am dealing with all the members of parliament are now facing a big challenge in trying to reform the so-called Muslim Marriage and Divorce Act, the MMDA reforms they call it. So that poses a different set of problems, because that's an internal intra-community matter. So in dealing with that, particularly the issue relating to the leadership of women comes into focus. Now I have been fighting even with our ulama, our leading religious dignitaries, that Quranic injunctions, hadith, sunnah of the Prophet, all of which have to be revisited, looking at the new context in which the advancement of women in society have come about. So all of you children here, ladies here, may be reading, may be looking at the debate that is going on. So I will invite you to look at these debates. In the coming days, it might intensify further, because if these reforms come into place, whether those reforms are meeting the standards that are expected of those reforms, or if they fail to meet those standards, we are bound to be criticized. But we are now attempting to bring about a consensus, some kind of flexible understanding about the need to readdress these issues in a new context.